An aspirin a day, does it keep the doctor away? Well, for women, not so much. Let's review an article that just came out recently called Cons of Regular Low-Dose Aspirin to Stave Off Serious Illness in Women Outweigh Pros. In other words, the British Medical Journal publication of Heart worded it this way: individualized prediction of alternate day aspirin treatment effects on the combined risk of cancer, cardiovascular disease, and gastrointestinal bleeding in healthy women. And this is what happened. You're going to find out it's kind of like a trade-off, but the risks, according to the British Medical Journal, far outweigh any potential benefit. You ready? Here we go. They based their findings on almost 30,000 healthy women who are at least 45 years old and taking part in the Women's Health Study. Participants were randomly assigned to take either 100 milligrams of aspirin or a dummy tablet, a placebo. Thanks for defining that for us. Every other day to see whether aspirin curbed their risk of heart disease, stroke, and cancer. And this is what they discovered. Compared with placebo, this is their words, not mine. Keep that in mind. So don't, again, don't sue me. Regular aspirin was linked to a lower risk of heart disease, stroke, bowel cancer, and in some women other cancers, but only marginally so. Sounds, marginally so. Well, what's the big deal? Marginally means like nothing. Ready? This is the trade-off, though, for that marginal impact. And this slight health gain was trumped by the prevalence of internal gastrointestinal bleeding, which affected 2/3. That means what? 66 out of 100 would get either minor gastrointestinal bleeding, peptic ulcers, and sometimes even worse, bleeding on the brain. But here we go. The research says, which would affect 2/3 of women taking the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. The researchers calculate that over 15 years, 29 women would have to take aspirin in order to prevent one case of cancer or heart disease or stroke. And you have to remember, that's about 3.4%, I would assume, if I did the math right. But they concluded, this is the researchers' terms, that blanket treatment is, their word, ineffective or harmful in the majority of women with regards to the combined risk of cardiovascular disease, cancer, and major gastrointestinal bleeding, this part. And in the British Medical Journal publication of Heart, they concluded it this way. Alternate day use of low-dose aspirin for primary prevention is ineffective or harmful in the majority of women with regard to the combined risk of cardiovascular disease, cancer, and major gastrointestinal bleeding. But they found out the older person got, the more benefit that seemed to yield with the aspirin. But the problem is, too, also at the same time, more likely you're going to have internal bleeding somewhere that you don't want anywhere, actually. So, in conclusion, aspirin is not a vitamin. No one's ever died of an aspirin deficiency. So, you have to weigh the risk, the benefit. If you believe that 1 out of 29 is a risk worth taking over the age of 65 in this case, then that's your prerogative. But if you feel like bleeding on the inside out 66% likelihood is not worth it, then that's your prerogative too. Thank you very much once again.
You need Anacin for fast relief. The big difference in Anacin makes a big difference in the way you feel. Minutes after taking Anacin,